Good afternoon, writers and readers. Welcome to the Writers' Roundtable. This week I'll be discussing the emergence of a new literary web genre called microflarf, or minimalist flarf. And it's derived from the movement known as flarf writing style. And this movement came about in the post-2000 millennium. Of course, it was led the way by such practitioners as K. Salem Mohammed, Sharon Mesmer, Drew Gardner, Gary Sullivan. I should just say to start, the technique for flarf writing style was that it developed out of using the Google search result technique, which is what you do is you type in a Google search with a variation of words. Here's a couple of books that I have from flarf writing style community. You can, in K. Salem Mohammed's book, The Front, the beginning of the poem is a good example of one of my favorite lines in the book. You don't know who I am, but I am a straight up person, and I am going to tell you things. Now that is freaking funny to me. Sign me up for rented space on your houseboat. Did I go see the Pink Panther remake when it came out? No and no. For me, the excitement is in the individual lines that just are so precise at capturing a tone. And the way that those individual lines are hemmed together within the flarf writing poem was not as interesting to me. Merge, coexist. Sometimes when I was finding my good lines using Google search results or other techniques, I didn't want them to be valued for the way they connect to other lines as much as the value they have in themselves. Now this is a line, a pair of lines that I found using Google search, using the words hipster and fuck. This is a line that was taken from my MSN messenger history. This was from a Google search result, for fuck you, and then something else, I don't remember what. This was a Google search result for fuck and then something else, I don't remember what. This was a Google search result for warp tour. And these are all microflarf because they take the idea of finding the text, putting it in a different location, taking it out of context. No, I don't like yet Justin Bieber. I freaking love him. If you go onto my Twitter account, you will notice even more flarf. My top tweet right now, random, you're gonna love me. That was from somebody's Twitter. Man, I got fucked up and went to the club and was mad cause the club was too packed as hell. I was born 55 years ago, not 55 minutes ago. I'm more than your dream, I'm your desire. So the issue with flarf tweeting style is that people don't often recognize, oh my god, the flarf nature. One time I tweeted something about not having a watch. I think I tweeted, I don't own a watch. And somebody tweeted back, I've been watch free for almost 3 years. This is the consequences. Also, when I flarf tweet, my follower numbers go down almost consistently. I'm down to 947 right now, whereas a couple days ago I was at 959 and I just started flarf tweeting more again. For a moment I dropped down under 900 when I was flarf tweeting hard for a couple days. I usually bring it back up when I actually communicate with other people on Twitter. I'll also show you my other Twitter account that I use, along with Pancho Peligroso. And this one is not always flarf proper. because here I'm taking such phrases as kitchen candle and just putting them. My new thing is twit picking with the Bieber account. That's it. I'm buying Wet Cat. And the picture is for Wet Cat. Now, I'm not the only one using microflarf on Twitter. If you look at Horse Ebooks, a popular Twitter account, it's getting some attention. With complete confidence, he said, "Go ahead and test the." No special skills are. So this is very funny. How to eroticize your body, period. No link. Okay, so this is a funny Twitter. Dear readers at home, next week I'm going to give you a conference video on flarf tweeting. It's going to go in depth at all my techniques at flarf tweeting. I want to leave you with one question. I'm thinking about renaming my blog. I'm just wondering, Writer's Paradise or Writer's Roundtable? Please leave a comment. As I always say, we're winning the web. So,